Hello students, welcome to a lesson through the virtual training center of the Brihan Mumbai Mahanagar Palika. My name is Shraddha teacher, and in this lockdown period, since we are not able to go to school children, we will be doing many lessons here online through the virtual class. So come on, let's proceed to our lesson for today.
Let us start yet another lesson today, children, for standard 2, and the subject is English, and the name of the lesson is Let's Speak. Okay, now this is lesson number 1.3 in your textbook. And children, if you see in your second standard English textbook, there are a lot of lessons on speaking, on reading, on writing, etc. Okay, so now before we go to the lesson and let us see what we are going to speak about, let us first understand what the meaning of speaking is, what the meaning of reading is. Okay, now when we do the later lessons, we will not do this introduction again, but since this is the first time we are talking about certain things in English which are required to learn the language, we will talk about a little bit of introduction to what is speaking, what is listening, etc. So now children, we all know that in the world people speak different languages. All right, now for example, if you look around you in your class also, you will see that certain children, they speak Hindi, certain children, they speak Marathi. Okay, some other friends of yours, they may speak Tamil, and then there are many other Indian languages like Telugu, Kannada, Punjabi, Bengali, etc. So these are all the different Indian languages. Okay children, now just like we have different languages in India, we also have different languages which are spoken around the world, and these are called as foreign languages. See, we do not know even how to read what they are trying to say. So some people are saying hola, some people are saying hello, and there is some alphabet letters which are written which we do not know how to read. So these are all children foreign languages. So we have Indian languages like Hindi, Marathi, etc., and we also have so many foreign languages which we do not know at all. But there is one foreign language that we all know and that we are all learning, okay, and our schools are also teaching us in this language. So what is that language, children? It is English. Okay, so out of these many different foreign languages, there is one foreign language that we know, we are trying to learn, and we are also going to a school which is teaching us in English. So let us try to understand more about this English language. So children, if you want to learn any language, there are four things that you should know, or there are four things that you should learn. See now, what is this girl trying to do? She has kept her hand near her ear, and there is something going inside her ear. It is the sound which is going inside her ear, and then she is understanding. Look at the expression on her face. Look at her eyebrow moving. Yes, she understood. So what is she doing? She is actually listening. Okay, so listening is a basic thing that you learn in any language. Now we will talk about English language because we are learning English. But remember, when I'm saying listening is a basic thing in English, it means it is a basic thing in learning any language. So if you want to learn Hindi also, you will have to listen carefully. If you want to learn Marathi also, you will have to listen carefully. If you want to learn Tamil also, you will have to listen carefully. Okay, so listening, and these are called as skills. Okay, so listening is a very important thing if you want to learn English. The next thing after listening is, see what are they doing? They are speaking. Okay, so you listen and you know how things are said, and then you learn to speak. Okay, so listening is one, which is very easy. You have to only keep your ears open, isn't it? You will be able to listen. Speaking is little more difficult compared to listening. So after you listen, you learn to speak. After you learn to listen and speak, then you try to learn to read. So reading is the next important thing for learning a language. Okay, so I told you, in our textbook, we are having all these things for you children. When your teacher says poems, when she repeats poems in class, you will learn to listen. When your teacher asks you a question and then you reply to your teacher in English, you will learn how to speak. And see, for reading, you have so many books, isn't it? You have textbooks from which you can read. So the next important skill in learning English is to read. And after reading, then you come to a very difficult thing, that is writing. Okay, so don't worry, even though it is a little difficult, we are going to learn all these things in our English textbook this year. So like I told you, listening you are doing since the first lesson when your teacher said the poem Bridges. That time you listened to your teacher, isn't it? Now in this particular lesson, we are going to talk about speaking. So see, what is this lady doing? She is speaking. Isn't it? So she's speaking to someone. We can't see who she's speaking to, but you can also speak to someone who is in front of you. Okay, you can speak to another person who's in front of you. You can also speak to a group of people. Can you see this man is speaking to so many people and all of them are nodding their head. Okay, so you can talk to many people at a time like this. See, he's talking to so many people at the same time. So speaking means when you speak to yourself, when you speak to your friend, when you speak to a number of people, all this comes under speaking. Speaking means saying something. Kuch bolna. Speaking means what? Bolna. Okay, so now we are going to talk in this particular lesson about speaking to welcome your friends. So when you want to welcome your friends, then what all things do you say? Okay, see, you have to speak in different times. You have to speak at different times. At home, when your mummy calls you and your mummy tells you, did you do your homework? That time you have to say yes, you have to say no. Okay, so that speaking is different. Suppose you go to school and you want to take your friend's pencil. You want to borrow your friend's pencil. That time also you have to speak, but that speaking is different. Now today we are going to talk about two different times when you might have to speak. One is when you welcome your friends. So can you see? These cartoons also, they are welcoming their friends, and the other children are also talking to each other. So welcoming your friends. So what do you say when you have to welcome your friends? Let us see what all words you will use in order to welcome your friends. What all words you will say in order to welcome your friends. Ab kya kya bolenge English mein jab aapko aapke friends ko welcome karna hai. That is what we are going to learn in this lesson on speaking today. Okay, so see here, this is the image in your textbook. Alright, and here see what they are saying to each other. They are saying hello, they are saying each other's names, they are saying hi, they are saying good morning. So learning from this page will be difficult for you. So let us go one by one. Let us take one dialogue at a time. Let us take one word at a time, one sentence at a time. So imagine you're meeting your friend. Okay, so what will you say to him? You can say hi. Or you can say hello. Or you can also say good morning. You can say good afternoon. You can say good evening according to the time of the day. But common thing, you can say hi or you can say hello. Okay. If it is morning, then you will say good morning. If it is afternoon, you will say good afternoon. And if it is evening, you will say good evening. Okay, so this is one common thing that you say when you meet someone. All right, after that, see, now this child, he's saying he is alone. Now here what happened? Here there were only one child talking to another child, one by one. Okay, one person was talking to another person. But here you will see this one child is talking to so many children. Okay, so now what will he say? He will say, hi friends, because there are more than one friend. There he had only one friend. So you said hi. He said hello. But here there are many friends. So what will he say? He will say hi friends. He can also say hello friends. Or he can say hi everyone. Everyone means all of you. So will he go to each person and say hi, 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 hi? No. He will say hi friends. He can also say hello friends. He will say hi everyone, or he can also say hello everyone when he is welcoming or when he is meeting many friends. Okay, so you can see all his friends are very happy and they will all reply to him. Remember, when someone says hi to you, what will you do? You will not keep quiet and look at that person's face. You will reply. Aap jawab doge. So what jawab they are giving? How are they replying? Let us see. So someone is saying hi. Someone else is saying hello. Someone else is saying hi again. And someone else is saying good morning. So this is how you can reply when someone greets you, when someone meets you. Okay, when someone says hi to you, when someone says hello to you, when someone says good morning to you, what will you speak back? You can say hi, you can say hello, you can say good morning. Okay, so this is how you will speak when you are meeting your friends, when you're welcoming your friends, when you're greeting your friends. Let us move on and let us see what these people are saying now. So see, along with saying hi, if you do not know your friends, if you're meeting your friends for the first time, you have to tell them your name also. So what will you say here? You will say, hi, I am Amit. Okay, now this boy's name is Amit. So he's saying, hi, I am Amit. So when someone tells you their name, then someone tells you, hi, I am Amit, what will you do? You also will have to reply by telling your name. So you can say, hi, I am Mala. Alright, so this girl's name is Mala. So see how Mala and Amit are welcoming each other, how they are speaking to each other. Once again, so Amit says, hi, I am Amit. He can also say, hello, I am Amit. And how is Mala replying? She's saying, hi, I am Mala. Okay, let us see one more example. See these two boys, they are also meeting each other without, they don't know each other's names. Okay, so see what is he saying? He's saying, hello, I am Gopi. And what is he replying? Raju is saying, hi, I am Raju. So when someone says hi, you can say hello. When someone says hello, you can say hi. So this is how you learn to speak. So now I have a small assignment for you. If you have your brother at home, if you have your sister at home, if brother and sister are not ready to play with you, then you can tell your mummy, and your mummy and you can play using these dialogues. Whatever we have learned now, na, you can tell your mummy hi, and you can tell your mummy your name, and then your mummy will also say hi to you. So you can play the small game in which you will learn how to speak. All right. So let us see what they are speaking in school when they're meeting for the first time. So he's saying, hello everyone, good morning, I am Satish. Okay, so this is the first day of school and so many new children are meeting each other. So see how all of them are telling their names also. So hello everyone, good morning, I am Satish. So what is the reply? Hello, I am Pramod. So his name is what? His name is Pramod. And what is this third little boy saying? He's saying, hi, I am Sidhu. And he's also saying, I am new in the school. He's new. He doesn't know anyone in the school. Okay. Then let us see what the other two children also are saying. So this boy is saying, I am Pranav. I am also new in the school. So Pranav is also new. And Sidhu is also new. And this girl, she is not new in the school. So what is she saying? See, she's saying, hi, I am Sharvari. Nice to meet you, my friends. Welcome to our school. So Sharvari is not new, okay? Sharvari was there in the school last year also. So Sharvari is welcoming everyone to the school by saying, welcome to our school. See, so how do you welcome someone? You say, welcome to our school. Now see this boy in the middle, he is new. And these two children are welcoming him to the school by saying, welcome to our school. And when someone says, welcome, what will you say? You will just stand and look at their face? No, you will say, thank you. Okay, whenever someone says welcome, you will always say thank you. All right, so this was about speaking, the first topic in this lesson where we spoke about welcoming someone. Now, when you welcome someone, it means you do not know that person. So you have to say hi, you have to say hello, you have to also say your name. Okay, now let us go to the next speaking point in the lesson where we will talk about where do you live. Come on, let's see what we will say if you want to ask someone about where they live. So this boy is asking the question, where do you live? Someone is asking you, where do you live? Means aap kahan rehte ho? Live means rehna. Okay, so someone is asking you, where do you live? So what answer will you give for where do you live, children? That means that person is asking you where your home is or where your house is. Okay, where do you live means aapka ghar kahan hai? Aap kahan rehte ho? So what answers can you give, children? See, you can give all these answers. You can say, I live in jo jagah pe aap rehte ho, us jagah ka naam. The name of the place where you live. So you can say, I live in, suppose Mumbai. So we will say, I live in Mumbai. Or you can say, I stay in Mumbai. Or you can say, I live near. Near matlab pass. So suppose there is a temple near your house. So what will you say? I live near the temple. If there is a hospital near your house, you can say, I live near the hospital. If there is a big tower near your house, you will say, I live near the tower. You can also say, my house is next to. Next to means bagal mein. Okay, so suppose your house is next to the temple. Matlab temple and then your house. So you will say, my house is next to the temple. If your house is near the temple, ekdam bagal mein nahi, but pass mein. So you will say, my house is near the temple. Okay, children? So these are all the ways in which you can speak. When someone asks you, where do you live? You can say, I live in Mumbai. I stay in Mumbai. I live near the temple. My house is next to the temple. My house is near the temple. So these are all the answers that you can give. Now let us look at what answers our friends have given here. So see, Satish is asking, where do you live? So let us see what answers he's getting. I live near the market. So market, bazaar. Near means pass me. Okay, I live near the market. So the market is very close to my house. Let us see what Sidhu is saying here. He's saying, I live next to our school. Next, matlab bagal mein. So there is the school and then there is Sidhu's house. Okay, so he says, I live next to our school. Not pass mein, but ekdam baju mein. Next to our school. And what is he saying? I live in Ramnagar. So this is a place, Ramnagar. So that is far away, I think. So he's saying, I live in Ramnagar. And what is this girl saying? So nice, we all live nearby. Okay, so what is she saying? She's saying, so nice, we all live nearby. We live near the school only. All right, children. So today we talked about speaking. Isn't it? And we talked about two things in speaking. How will you speak when you want to welcome your friends? And how will you speak when you want to ask, where do you live? So how will you answer when you want to ask, where do you live? Or when someone asks you, where do you live? So this was our lesson based on speaking today. So children, now you have watched the video. So after you watch the video now, you will have to complete a few simple tasks. Now you might have watched the video on your computers or your laptops or your mobile phones. Now after you watch the video, what will you do? You will please go to the description box which is given below the video. So what is the description box? See, the description box looks like this. All right. And after you go to the description box, you will see that there are a few questions there. Now, what are these questions about? These questions are about the lesson that we just learned or the video that you just watched. So what will you do? You will think back properly about the lesson and you will try and answer these questions. And note down the answers in your notebook if you want. Okay. After that, we have another task waiting. You will also click on the link which you will find in the description box to fill up the Google form. So now what is the Google form, children? It is nothing but a simple form. There are a few simple questions there about the video which you just saw. And also about yourself. So these are the tasks now that you will have to complete after you watch each video. So children, wasn't that a very interesting lesson? I'm sure you learned a lot of new things in this lesson. If you have liked this video, please hit the like button and also subscribe to my video so that you will get to see all the videos which I keep posting regularly.